Hello everyone, this is Doc Aaron. Welcome back to another Minecraft Redstone video. In this video, we're going to be looking at this thing, the Redstone comparator. Today, I'm going to be showing you how the Redstone comparator works and how to use it in your Redstone contraptions. So let's crack on with this amazing tutorial. First functionality of the Redstone comparator, although it's really not its big one, but you need to understand this. If you have a Redstone torch over here, and I didn't mean to do that, and some redstone going like this, this is a redstone strength of 14. This outputs as a redstone strength of 14. So these two are exactly the same. So you could have, although this is incredibly inefficient, I suggest not doing this whatsoever, a long stream of comparators, and this redstone right here will be the same as over here, even though it's all these blocks away. Now, I'm not sure why you would use this function in the way that I just showed you, as it's way easier to just use a repeater, although it can be useful, I think. And the other thing that you could do with a redstone comparator is it can, just like a repeater, detect redstone through blocks, except it actually has to be powering the block. Don't do what I just did. And, am I doing something wrong? Oh, right, that's not actually what it... Ignore that. The second redstone functionality, which I was trying to show you, was that it can actually detect items from... it can actually detect inputs from specific blocks, such as chests, for example. It can even through blocks. It detects stuff in the chest based off how many items are in it. And right now, it's redstone strength of 0, but if I put an anvil in this chest for random reason why I would need an anvil at the moment, you can see that it turns the comparator on. Right now, however, it only has a redstone strength of 1. When this chest is completely full, either of non-stackable items or of stackable items or both, it will output a signal strength of 15. Now, this is something you need to be quite sure about, because this is actually or a feature of the redstone comparator. You can put it in subtract mode, or you could just leave it as is, one way or the other, and then have a chest going into it, and it will subtract this value from this, or it'll subtract whatever's coming from here to here. If you have it out of subtract mode, if this input is greater than this input, then this will turn off, and it won't subtract this input from this input. Does that make sense? Don't forget that this can also be powered through a block if you really wanted it to. This can be used for compacting redstone contraptions. I've used it on a couple of occasions, but a misconception is that these know exactly how many items are in each chest and are inputting that value into each other. That's not the case. If it was, that'd be absolutely amazing. It might be the case in Java Edition. I'm still pretty sure it's not. But, yeah, if I were to put an extra item in here. Give me a second. I need to check to make sure this is working. Yeah, if I were to put another item in there, even though it's a different item, it still counts as only two items being in the chest, and there will only be a redstone strength of 1. So, if you have one item in this chest, and this is not in subtract mode, so let's take this, and one item in this chest, sorry, two items in this chest, it will not subtract this, as it's the exact same signal strength going from here into this. I hope that made sense for you. And the next feature of the redstone comparator is to take out, I already mentioned it takes outputs out of chests. It can take outputs out of cauldrons, for example. It can take and put outputs from lecterns, which is incredibly useful. Composters, it can take barrels, anything that can store items. I'm not sure if it takes inputs from furnaces and such. It might. It takes inputs on daylight sensors, observers, of course, anything that can give it a redstone output, it takes a redstone output from, and of course, the command blocks. Now, that is a lot of things to take outputs from, and it also takes output from activator rails and detector rails. forgot to mention that. It also takes outputs from whether an end portal is activated or not. It also takes an output from jukeboxes. And that's pretty much it for the redstone comparator, although one quick thing about the jukebox is the signal strength will be different for whatever type of music that you play. For the sake of argument, I'm just going to play Cat, because Cat's my favorite. Cat's most people's favorite. Think about it. It's Dan TDM's favorite. It's Mumbo Jumbo's favorite. I ran out of people that think it's their favorite. Okay, moving on. Anyway, if you enjoyed the video on how to use a redstone comparator in less than 3 minutes, please be sure to hit that like button. If you do, if you really did like it, please be sure to subscribe. This has been Doc Aaron, and I'm out. See you all later. And I just realized that the tutorial is actually 5 minutes long. Sorry about that. I thought it was going to be 3 minutes long. What was I thinking?